happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. Today I am on my map doing some testing here of the sell points. I'll kind of show you guys, I've done a lot of stuff. I'll show you a few things that I can show in-game, the rest I'll show, well, I guess I can actually show it all. So if you see, down in... kind of down where I am here, there's a whole bunch of fields, and then there's a giant field as well. Been working on a bunch of fields. This is kind of like the area where it's a bunch of small fields, kind of more so for starting out. And then this big section that you see here, this will be split in half, and then one section will be like some medium-sized fields, and then the other section will be a bunch of large fields. So, kind of splitting this area up and whatnot. I've added a different dealership. Or not dealership, a different elevator. This one I took off of Random Sparks's FS17 Central Valley map. I ran the building through Blender and then imported the bins here and put on the suck-up logos. Brought in a scale. As you can see here, I have the probe in, it does not work yet. I haven't added the probe or animation map trigger in yet. That'll be the next task. I had lost a bunch of progress, that's why this field's so much different and stuff is different. I had lost a bunch of progress, my map files became corrupt, so I had to redo a whole bunch of stuff. I'm sure I've already said that, but so then I put the sugar beet thing here. Evidently all of my piles. Oh, that's right. I need to fix that to make my piles be above ground and not under, because I don't want these. Because right now it's trying to make these a storage trigger. But I do have a sell point trigger on here. I don't know why it's still doing that. I'll have to mess with that. And then if we run over here, I am going to be adding a different dealership fairly soon. But here, as you can see, we have Crop Production Services. This is the main building. You can get some mixed fertilizer in here. You can get your dry fertilizer anyways. You can get your liquid fertilizer there. And then here, this is a purchasable point. Basically what that is, like, I could take like the Brandt auger, stick it in here and fill trailers from here with like an auger or a conveyor or like a bucket, and it'll purchase it bucket by bucket. Here is the seed storage shed. We have some blue treated seed, red, green, orange, and purple. This one, the image that I used is a little bit smaller, so it kind of blew up. I'm assuming that's beans. This is kind of like a wheat or something. This is maybe a bean or something. That's got the purchase trigger there. And then if we run over here, we have another scale here at the sale barn. Oh, I did not move that one. I need to do that. Kind of change this up a little bit as well. So, made a few changes. But what we're going to need to do is, I'm testing sell points right now. Like I said, so we're going to go ahead and buy a combine. We're going to get the gleaner. We're going to get a header for that. We're going to get the biggest of these gleaner heads. Actually, no. I'm going to get a... Oh, yeah, we'll use that one. We need a hopper. Oh, we need a hopper and an end dump. Because I'm testing wheat for the elevator and then sugar beets for the piler. The truck, we're going to get the new to me 389 Pride and Class. We're going to go ahead and get it in red. This truck is private. I will just say that right now. So sorry for no uploads lately. I have been focusing on some other stuff. I actually just got a job yesterday, and I got hired at Skyzone, which, for those of you that don't know what Skyzone is, it's basically an indoor trampoline park. There's all kinds of different stuff in there, and my boss is actually my old scout troop leader from like 5 years ago, so it's kind of funny how that worked out. But yeah, it's kind of neat how that ended up. And I got hired there, and last night I went for orientation, and then me and the five other people that were hired, we all got to jump around for a while after the orientation was done, and then went back home afterwards. And I haven't gotten anything recorded yet, so I probably will be keeping the video current schedule for the most part, because Skyzone doesn't open during the week until 4 p.m. Obviously, I won't start right at 4 all the time, being as my schedule is a little bit more open. I am able to work a little more, so doing like some cleanup or some maintenance or whatever else needs to be done. Yeah, so it'll be kind of neat. Let's see what else. Yeah, that's about it. I have had a few people asking me about my pickup before, and I did do a video, but I'm pretty sure I mentioned in that video that I needed to get a new battery. If I didn't, well, I did need to get a new battery. I did finally get a new battery yesterday as well. I went and got one before my interview, and I didn't get it put in because it was later when I got home. And then also, it was really super windy, and it's even worse today. We're actually in like a wind advisory, high wind advisory or something, and so I'm not gonna get it done today. Hopefully tomorrow the wind will be pretty much dead and I'll be able to put it in. So I'll do a video of that and then starting it up. The planter didn't shut off like I thought it did right here, so oh yeah, I kind of have a little spot here. Kind of sucks that this combine does not like this header, but nobody's done a grain head to go with it, so or set it up for additional heads and whatnot. So we're just going to combine, and then once the combine gets full or we finish this, I'm probably going to be able to just combine all of this or a very large majority of it, because I didn't fertilize it. I'm not really worried about getting like a super huge amount. You know what, we'll actually go like this. Set auto combine. And then while that guy does that, we can go and harvest some beets. So get this thing unfolded. So this is just kind of like a little bit of an update video, and then just also something to have a video out. I don't know what I'm gonna do for this week, if I wanna do the actual schedule or just record a couple of mapping videos and call it good. I've spent pretty much all day working on this, trying to get all this town stuff back. Been kind of a pain, but it's gotta get done, so. So that's what I've been working on, and so yeah, it's pretty much what my day has consisted of. That, and I've been trying to get the animation map trigger added, and I don't know why, but I am having like zero luck doing it. And I've followed the little tutorial that I found. I've copied off other maps, and I still can't get it. But when I fired up this map, I had a thought. Well, I added it to my will map. I know it works. I'll just copy everything off of that one because I know it works. I personally added that, so I'll try that. So I'll have to try that after I'm done testing here. And see if that works, maybe. Only annoying thing about that gleaner is once it hits, it's got the same issue as the New Holland TR-99, where the pipe will be out anywhere above 80%, but any other time it won't come out. It doesn't recognize your tractors and trucks and whatnot, so that's annoying, but with that, we'll just have to dismiss the hired worker and then holy cow, that was fast. And just have to dismiss the worker and then unload it and then hire the worker again. I do want to make some more American sugar beet equipment in the future, you know, to use on this map, because I will be doing beets quite often on this map, because, you know, as I've mentioned before, beets are a very common thing in the Red River Valley, you know, kind of near where this is based. So there's a lot of sugar beet pilers, there's a lot of sugar beet fields, and it'd just be kind of nice to have some real American sugar beet equipment. I know there's been a few sugar beet machines released, but most of them are either European or kind of crap. So really, it's only one row that it's picking up. That's ridiculous. But yeah, so, you know, having my map been, my map having been corrupted and me having to redo some stuff kind of came as a blessing in disguise, I'll say, because, you know, I've redone so much stuff, I've done things differently, and I kind of like the way that things have gone now, you know, like with these field, all these small fields, and making that into some medium sized and some large, you know, having the piler over there, a different elevator, CPS there, you know, the sale barn the way it is now, and, you know, all that stuff. I like it a whole lot more than the way it was before. So a whole lot nicer, you know. And as I was saying with the sell point testing, you know, I'm not worried about having a whole bunch of crop to use to test with. I'm just more so, I, you know, if this 9,000 liters was all I had, that would be perfectly fine, you know, because it would tell me if it works or not, you know. But I mean, I planted this whole field, so I'll just use the whole field. And so, yeah. Obviously, the way that I'm harvesting right now is not the way that I'll be harvesting when the map is actually finished, because there will be fence around everything. And what I've decided with the fencing is I'm going to go through, add every single field in, and then I'm going to go back and fence like all of these small fields to start with. And then that way I can start playing on the map, because these are the fields that I'll be starting off with. And then I can, you know, kind of as I go, I can put in the, I can kind of put in other fences slowly and as I go and whatnot. So that's kind of the thought that I've had in terms of doing that. So this is the new 389 Pride and Class. Pride and Class. Pretty awesome truck. I really, really like it. Just actually downloaded it today. This is an ATS truck. Converted by the owner of Canadian Farming and Modding. That's why. Hence the CFM on the trailer, or the emblems. Jeez. And it does have a selectable log rack as well, which is kind of neat.
Whoa.
Kind of got way off there. So yeah, we can take a walk around the truck here once. I like the move over on the front flaps here. It's got a Caterpillar engine in it, 840 horsepower. 840 horses of pure lean, mean American machine. Nice chrome cube map. Overall, great looking truck. Great working truck as well. I've had a lot of fun with it already. Like I said, I am going to be changing the dealership, possibly to something a little bit bigger and a little bit cooler, I'll say. I do need to also make the lot bigger at the dealership, like a lot bigger, because it's kind of hard to get equipment in and out, or, you know, get it hooked up and get it driven out without having to drive over tons of grass. And so I'd like to make the lot a little bit bigger. And I could move the dealership back a little bit as well. It doesn't need to be quite as far forward as it is. It could go back a little ways, but if I'm going to add a new one, I'm not even going to worry about it. Fuel triggers work. The seed trigger works, obviously, and I haven't done anything with the fertilizer yet. Maybe I can show you guys that in this video. I'll show you how the viable thing works. The doors on Century 21 and that shop there do not work, and I'm sure that's just because I don't have the animation map trigger script added in yet. Same with the grain probe over there. And that grain probe will actually be at a couple of the farms as well, like mostly the large farm, like the large crop farms. Goodness, it'll just be at like the. I think I'm gonna do like two large farms. That's probably what I'm gonna do, something like that. So Which I do need to start adding the farms fairly soon, or start figuring out where I want them, because, you know, with these fields, as I'm adding more and more of them, I'll probably just add all the fields and then go back and remove field as needed. That's probably what I'll do, but I don't know, I haven't decided yet how I want to work all that. I do like this Homer harvester though. This thing is pretty nice. So we have steering mode turning, flexible steering, that's okay, that's like that. We have crab left, crab right. Steering, so let's go crab steering left. Never actually used the crab steering. I don't really know why you would, but I'm sure there's a reason for it. Maybe you avoid driving on stuff more or something, I don't know. So I guess we'll just kind of harvest this until that combine's done, and then I'll just call it quits, because I'll have enough sugar beets then to test enough stuff. So in, you know, continuing with talking about making sugar beet stuff, also would include, you know, making like some sugar beet trucks, like some straight trucks, maybe, you know, like turning the C70 into a potato truck, or a beet truck, I mean, and, you know, having some older style and newer style straight trucks, that'd be kind of nice, kind of neat. I think BC Bueller modding had made some straight trucks for beets and or potatoes at one point. They looked pretty neat. So I think what we'll do is we'll just get to the end of this row here and we'll call it good with the beet harvester. So we got our pipe out, so we're gonna drop that there. We're just gonna drive out through the grass here. There's our turn. Jeez. The visor kind of makes it hard to see in first person. Kind of comes down really low. But it makes it look super cool. I think it looks awesome. Okay, so we're going to run over here. We're going to unload that and we'll test out sugar beets. And I'm pretty sure I changed the triggers. Unless my map is going all funky or something. Alright, so let's check this out here. We'll see how all this works. Made the entrance nice and big, so that way you can, wait, we're going on the wrong side, aren't we? Oh, no. Loaded trucks goes on this side. Okay, so, I need to check. Okay, so our weight is 27,719. And I just need to check and make sure that this other side is working. Cool. I had done some work to these to make it so that you can see the weight on both sides of the scale. Before it would have only been on our left side when we're coming on to the, Okay, so my beat trigger does not work. Okay, so I'll need to fix that. Okay, well, let's get rid of these trailers then. And this. And hopefully our elevator works otherwise. I actually want to just check something here. I want to see if these lights come on at night. Cool, they do. That's cool. I'll have to take these lights and put them in other places as well. Like put them over here at the elevator, and that's pretty nice. I always like it when stuff like that works, like it should and whatnot. Okay, so we'll let that guy fill up as well, and I need to move my signs down still. So still got some stuff, but that's what testing in game is for. Get that unloading. We're gonna jump to this guy, dismiss him, shut him off. This cleaner isn't a bad model. Could use a fair amount of work, but it gets the job done. Okay, so we can sell the combine and header now. We'll hop in our truck, we'll go over here. We'll do some testing here at the elevator, and then I'll show you guys what I've been talking about with the viable fertilizer. Yeah, that definitely does not work. We're gonna back up here and take a picture on the scales. Close that. So what do we weigh here? 38,696. We'll hop in here and let's go ahead and sell. It does show up Heartland Co-op, so we're going to be selling $493 a ton. I'd like to figure out how to set these prices just a little bit higher. I mean, not much, but I definitely would like them to be higher a little bit. So, okay, so this trigger is fully functional and working. We are making money. So let's find out how much money we made from that little bit. It's not even going to show me. Okay, I probably showed it already when I had the HUD closed. 26,800 pounds even. So I also want to check and see if the direct sell point is working as it should on here. I don't know why the Jake brake isn't working on this truck. It is scripted in. I think. I don't know. The scripts for it are in the folder. I don't know if they're set up or not. Alright, so that works. Okay, so now we're going to buy an auger wagon. We'll get the Sacandaic, or whatever it is. I don't know how you pronounce that. I'm assuming that's what it is, but. And we'll get. Let's see how well it works with one of these trailers. See if one of these would accept fertilizer. I think I had to add it to. Yeah, fertilizer's in there. I think I had to add it to my multi-fruit or something like that. I can't remember how I got that to work the first time that I did it. Check out the Olic live bottom trailer, see if this will work. See how this will work with that. So let's see if we can purchase from inside the building first. No, we cannot. Okay, so plan B. Checking out here. I will also test. Really? Straight's all that this thing will do? Oh, that's why those wheels need to be on the ground. Gotcha. That would make sense. This will be kind of a slow drive here, but so we'll put the hopper on, or no, that can stay off. Remember what all mouse functions there are on this thing. Let's see, so there's those. Oh, just those ones then, okay. Gotcha. This is actually the same motor that I used on the C70 liquid tender truck. Wish we could buy that and test out the liquid trigger. There is also a storage thing for this, but I'm not going to use it. So you can see we are buying fertilizer. So let's hop on our truck to see if we can load. Yeah, we just took out the auger. So, unfortunately, we cannot load into this trailer. I think I can use this end dump, though. Let's try it out, but let's fix this auger first. Okay, so we're just going to take a shortcut, of course. Just get this over with. So the commodity shed there that I'm using, it's the shed from Clover Creek, but using the textures from the one on Central Valley, the map that Random Sparks released for FS17. So a 15... model with 17 textures, which the 17 one is obviously the 15 one just reskinned. So it's the same thing, but there we go. Now we're filling up with some fertilizer. So yeah, that's how that works. See a dump in there, and we are purchasing it, so then you can take it, you could go to your farm if you have a storage trigger for fertilizer, you can dump it there, or you can just purchase it as you need it. You could buy an auger and put it there to come by with your fertilizer spreader or whatever. So we'll let that fill, and while that does that, we're gonna go ahead and we'll get the C70 tender truck, the liquid tender. We'll go with black. And then we'll also get a fertilizer spreader and tractor. We'll just get, let's see, what's a good tractor? We'll get the Oliver 1955. It's underpowered, of course, but that doesn't really matter. We're not spreading with it. This is my edit of the Oliver 1955. I did get permission. I don't know if I said this yet or not. I did get permission to release it, and I had uploaded it to FS UK, but there's one error in the log that about the dirt normal texture not being able to be located, and then there's a thing about, and then they also want me to make the animations work and slow down the speed a little bit, so I figured I'll fix those issues and re-upload and whatnot. So let's see here. Can't load resource. Yep, texture shared, dirt normal. So fix that. That's basically just putting the dirt shader in a different location, and that's it. And then the speed, that's just an adjustment in the XML file, although I don't see why it's a problem. The guy said 27 kilometers an hour. It's 26 miles an hour. I don't know what the difference is. He found it on tractordata.com is what he said, so I guess I'll have to go on there and do a little bit of research. See if I can find out what its deal is. Fix it or whatever. So my trigger in here does not work, period. So I'll just need to add a different one in from it. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull it right over here. We're gonna go left control R, and we're gonna dump this right here. That's quite the interesting texture that this has for fertilizer. Wait, that file's not. Oh. Definitely did that a realistic way, huh? No, I want you off. So, yeah. 89%, 66%. So yeah, that's kind of a video. I'm gonna go in and fix some stuff on here, add the animation map trigger stuff, get the probe working, and a whole bunch of other stuff. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are definitely worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow. Maybe, anyways. We'll see. We'll see you guys later, that's what I'll say.